Hey there, it's Kevin from Synthesia, and today I'm going to show you how I build a training video from start to finish. I'll keep my camera rolling the whole way as I try to build this video here, and you'll be able to see each click, each decision that I make, all the way from copying and pasting my script into my script box to downloading the final video after we click generate. I'm a little bit nervous because I haven't put this all together in one go, so I'm not sure how it's gonna go, but let's get to it. All right, so what am I starting with? Before we even get into the studio and start editing, I always have to start off with a script. And so our video here is about how to give and receive feedback. It's gonna be a course intro, but I always start with a really good script. And as you can see here, I've taken my script that's in the middle here, and I break it up into 2 to 3 sentence chunks. The reason for that is I want to keep the pacing fast. I want what's on screen to be changing around every 10 to 20 seconds just to keep my viewers' interest as they're going through this video. So you'll see I have on my other tab here, I've got Synthesia STUDIO. I'll just show you how I build. This is the video editor that I use, but you should be able to follow along with this process and also build your video pretty easily. So first things first, I click on new video and I'm gonna use a template because I am not a visual designer. So I'm choosing this template. The first step here is that I want to, even before I start to begin to put my script into the script box, is I'm gonna start putting in the different layouts. So first I wanna start off with a title screen to introduce what my video and my course is going to be about. So I'll start with that title layout here. The next layout I'm gonna add is I want to get my learners excited about this course and what they could hope to achieve. So I'm going to add this layout here using stock footage. Then we're gonna cut back to my narrators to say, hey, I'm gonna be your course guide. This is the person you should look for at different parts of the experience to follow along and for when things pop up. Next, I'm going to tell them what the course is about. So I'm gonna find this nice layout that shows, okay, this is the 4 different things that are going to be in the course, the 4 different lessons. So I want something that's like a table of contents. And then finally, I'm gonna cut back to my presenter to say, hey, I'll be your guide. I'll be here for certain learning activities along the way, but let's get started. So they're gonna be sort of this voice to engage my viewer. So we've already done that first step. Next is that we're gonna choose who we want to be our presenter. And so in this case, right now we have our friend Emery here. I'm just gonna replace him with somebody who is, maybe I think is going to be a better fit for my audience. Maybe they want to see someone in a suit. So I have my friend Leah here, who I think is gonna be a good replacement for Emery. So now we have our avatar that's gonna be our speaker on all the different screens ready to go. Next, I'm going to, let's say I wanna change the colors maybe to match her suit. So I'm just gonna make some small changes here, like matching the color of her dress suit to the template so that she kind of pops a little bit more. So I like that background and you can see it's changed these greens to navies. All right, so here we are at our next step, where we're going to copy and paste our script directly into the script box. So this is gonna serve as our voiceover when putting together our video. And we already divided the script into 2 to 3 sentence chunks to keep things moving. So I'm just gonna erase the script that we have here, and I'm gonna copy and paste my script in each scene. And I don't want you to have to stick around for that, so I'm gonna speed things up just a little bit. Okay, so at this point, you can see for each scene, we have the script in the script box. Now, we don't really need to take care of a voiceover because we're using an AI tool, so this is where we will start to change what's on screen. We have to think about what we're using to visualize each part. So whenever I, as a rule of thumb, typically with an avatar, I always start at least the intro with an avatar, so I like to have a talking head right up front. And I like to have them at the end just as a way to wrap things up and say, hey, this video is coming to a close. We have other ways that we can visualize some of our script. I've already made these decisions along the way where maybe something like this, where instead of having my narrator just talking the whole time, I want to change things up and go with stock footage. In this case, I went with a video of some folks high-fiving, so you can see that looks something like this. And sometimes we just need text on screen to, you know, give us titles or to talk about important things that we really want to highlight from the message. So what I'm going to do at this point is I'm going to make the changes to the text on screen, swap out what's on the template for, you know, the titles and the things that we want people to read. Okay, so at this stage, we can already see that some of the scenes are already finished. So for example, scene one, it looks like I have my title and all my text on screen. I've changed the text on screen here. Okay, so for this scene, you can see that I'm missing a chyron that introduces my avatar. And I know that sometimes for talking heads, you want to have a chyron or some sort of description that pops up in the bottom, like it does here, to introduce kind of who you're speaking to. So I'm going to show you how I create that. First, I start out by using a shape. I'm just gonna drop that into the lower third, drag that down, and stretch it out. But it shouldn't pop out too far. And I'm gonna use this opportunity to color match it with the template. It's okay if it's hanging off the side. That's just gonna make sure that it's only gonna animate or show you what's in frame. So I'm not too concerned about that. Then I'm gonna take some text that's from our another part of our template, and I drop that in right there and unlock those so I can move them around. And now I just write in my title and the name and the title of this person. In this case, we're gonna call our avatar Isabella Garcia in this video, and we're gonna say she's our learning expert and course guide. Now, if I were to play this, you would see that nothing would happen because I've just placed these objects. I haven't told them how to animate or what to do. So in order to get these things moving, we have what's called animation markers, which you can find here, where what you do is you essentially just put a marker down, like I do here, in the script where you want something to start animating. And the beauty of this is you no longer have to sit with your stopwatch and guess and check, did the animations line up with when they were mentioned in the script, or did the text pop up when it's mentioned in the audio? Well, now you can just drop in that marker, and we're gonna tie each object to a marker. So first things first, I'm gonna animate this chyron to come in, slide in from the left, right at the scene start, but then I want Isabella Garcia to fade in right when it's mentioned. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select an animation, set the delay to zero, and put an animation marker and tie that to flag number one. And what that says is when you get to flag one, look at that object and start to fade it in right away. The same here with the title, it's mentioned a little bit later in the script. I'm going to have it fade in, make sure the delay is set to zero, and set it to come in on the second flag. So this is what it looks like now.
Hi, I'm Isabella Garcia, your learning expert and your guide for the next few lessons.
Excellent. So you can see that it comes up right when it's mentioned in the script. Now, I have the same thing to do with these objects here, where at each part of the script that I want these to fade in, I'm going to go in here, drop in an animation marker for each one. All right, that's it. Now I have all of my parts. I think I have the script on each page. I've got my the things that need to be animated are now animated. And now all that's left for us to do is to title this video. So, and now I get to hit the, let's add a little bit of music. I'm sorry. I love to add music just, you know, at the beginning of something to kind of get the emotion going, get a little bit of engagement going. So looking through here, let's add this music. And now I hit generate video. Here you can see that I can choose to add my captions or not. I typically like to have my captions burned in so I don't have to worry about the video being more accessible to folks, but I can also take those off and download the SRT file later. I'm gonna click generate video and I'll see you in a little bit. So this is the last stage of building a training video. when we finish our video, we're not quite yet done because we have to think about how we're gonna get it in front of viewers. So if you're in a learning context, the way that I'm gonna do that here is that, you know, I can play my video here and kind of see, did my production turn out okay? Or I could do something else. I can click on these three dots here and I can download my video as an MP4, which could be good if I wanna upload it into another platform. I can also use this opportunity to download the subtitles if I didn't have them burned into my video. This will download an SRT file that's based directly off the script. So you know it's gonna be perfect and just what you need. The other way is when I hit publish here, I'm gonna click public access, and I have this option to copy an embed code. And if you're familiar with this, this is just the HTML, your iframe code, that's gonna say, hey, here's a video that's hosted somewhere, play it in your content management system. So if you copy that embed code, you should be able to just drop that right into your LMS or CMS and your video will appear there with a video player every single time. If you were looking to share the video with other folks, you could do that as well. But for now, let's just stick to the MP4 and embedding the HTML code into our content management system. That's all for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm relieved that that's over and we got that video all together. I can't thank you enough for sticking around through this whole video. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe to follow along for more Synthesia Academy content or advice on how to build training videos with AI avatars. That's all for now. We'll see you down the road.